Before I had created some continuous beams. Now that we are pursuing with the details, maybe I could also take care of that. So you see the beams are like this. They go all the way from grid number A to grid number D, but I want to change them to beams which cover the span between the grids. So I'm going to select one of the beams and I want to go with split here. Okay, so now this is that beam, this is the other beam. I want to move this over there. Oh, actually, let me move this down. Okay, now I'm going to use align. And here, so this is now correct. Okay, and on this side, align. Now it's one beam over there, one beam over there, and one beam over there. Now let's create one of the details such as this one. In this detail, we have the floor, the two columns, the lower part just attaches to the floor. The upper part has a little bit of a gap. These are the beams, and to have a better visualization, let me show you this detail. So we have the column here, we have a plate, and on this side and that side where we have the beam, we have some connectors. And we have a hole here for the plate. And the plate is connecting to the column using four rods, each of which has a diameter of 16 millimeters. Okay, so if I come to the Revit file, this seems a good location in my second section to create a call out. So I want to go to the view, call out, and create one in here. I can name it as typical girder column connection. So we can do it here, rename it. Okay. So this is the callout. I definitely need to change this to fine. Because this is a typical one, we don't need to see the grid, so I'm gonna hide it in view. So maybe I could start with the plate over there. Over there, we should add a plate. So let's create that plate first. If I put these two views side by side, this is the column. And this is the beam over there. So I'm gonna put the plate on top of this column. Okay, I can go to the structure tab, component, place a component, can go to load family. And if we go to the folder search our connections, and mounting parts, we should have a plate in here, fastening plates. We can use this one, open, and we can put it on top of the surface. If you go with place on face here, and if I change this view to wireframe, you can see it there. Okay, I can use a line to align it with the center line of the column. So that's turned around. I should be able to also align it on this view. If I go to a different view, I can also align the plate here, so it's exactly on the middle. Okay, a couple of things about this element. You can switch that up and down like this. Okay, what we want to do is to match whatever we know about the plate with this element here. Okay, so I'm going to go here. This is going to be that plate at the bottom. If I go to a different view, you see that this is the plate and those are the rods. So a couple of things here is that we know the rods are 16 millimeters in diameter for both at the top part and at the bottom here. So I can take care of that by going to edit type. I want to duplicate it and name it as plate for wood. Okay. How about I change the rod radius to 16 millimeters? Okay. Now, if I go here, as you see, this is on level foundation, but we are on level 2, so I can change the level here to L2. Okay. We can also, let me move this down. Okay. We don't have exact dimensions for the plate width, but we can more or less guess it. So if this is about 300 millimeters here, the plate should be maybe 250 by 250 or 300 by 300, okay? So I can change the plate dimension if I click on it. Plate bits, how about I go with 300 by 300 and see how it works. Okay, now it's getting a bit better. We also need to take care of the hole spacing vertical and the hole spacing horizontal. And we don't have the exact number, so let's see if we can make some estimation here. This is the hole dimensions. The other video shows that it's a square. So we can go, it's about 1/3 of the width. So maybe it's about 100 by 100 or 120 by 120. So I'm gonna go with maybe 120 by 120 here. It's a little bit better. So this is the column. And that's it. Also, we need to make the rods a little bit longer. We don't have the dimension again here, but if this is 300, maybe this is also 300. So I want to change the anchor length to 300 at least. Okay. Now I want to make sure the column ends right below the floor. So I can select the column and use attach top base. Okay. Now this part looks like this part. We have the plate and the rods, and the plate ends at the top of the column, which is all good. I can change this to wireframe so we can see the rods better. Now for the top part, we also need to consider the column to start a little bit above the floor. So I'm going to select this column and I want to assign maybe 30 millimeters to the base offset. Actually, maybe a little bit more. Okay, so I want to select this column. I want to change this number maybe to 50. We need more, so it's maybe 100. Okay, so this looks more like this. We have a space here. I want to reset everything here. And I want to duplicate this 3D view. And I want to rename this as Exploded Isometric Detail. So I'm going to rename it as Exploded Isometric Detail. Okay. Right click somewhere and hide in view category or element. Okay. Also, I want to hide these columns in here. Actually, I want to hide them using this item. I want to hide these as well. And maybe also this beam system here. So this column is this column. I can also hide this one. Now we can create another plate right below the top column as it shows in this detail. So I want to go to the Structure tab, Component, and I want to use this surface. Okay, I can select it and use the plate wood type that I created. I can align the element to the center line here. So you see the spacing is 50. We consider the spacing to be 120, 120 here. Also, the plate width is 100. It seems that it's not as long as this plate, but maybe around 200 for the width and the length. I also need to open maybe L2 and center this plate here. So I want to go with the align again. Okay, so now we have the plate over there. How about we increase the anchor to be maybe 300, same as the ones we had below. We don't have the exact dimension for that element over there. I considered 120, but maybe it could be 150. We can check. Might make more sense here as well. Okay. So now we have the top part, the top plate, the bottom plate. Now we only need the connecting element at the middle. Now for this part, I want to add a 150 by 150 steel element. Maybe I can go to the structure, column, load family. I want to go to structural columns, steel, and use one of these hollow ones. Okay. 150 by 150 should be good. I need to go with the vertical column. I just want to put it here. Okay, now I want to select this. It needs to start on level 2, so I'm going to start on level 2, and I want the offset to be about 200 millimeters, so it's like this. How about I go to here, I'm gonna go to edit type and change the values here a little bit, maybe 120 by 120. The file does not have the dimension of this element, so I'm just guessing. Okay, it fits there. Almost, okay. Okay, how about I go with 110 by 110? Okay, and I'm going to change this to 110, 110. Okay. Nice, better. Let's compare it with the detail here. It seems that it starts from the plate in here and connects to the plate over there. So maybe it could go a bit lower in here. I want to take a quick dimension from here to here is 89. I want the base offset to be negative 89, so I can change that top offset to 100. That seems about right. Okay, so we have a plate over here, a little seal column, and another plate over there.